To the Philippine benchmark index now, the PSEI deepens its losses on Wednesday, with the main index shedding 1.4%, though still at the 6,800 level. Value turnover was at 4.3 billion pesos. Joining us now for a take on today's trading, we have Denise Joaquin of COL Financial. Denise, welcome to the Business Roadshow.
Hi, Stanley. Nice to be here.
All right. Now, first, maybe you can analyze the market performance for us today. What highlights might you be able to give us about share prices as well as trading volumes as of the moment?
Okay, so today we continue to see another downward move after the market tried to break out of a consolidation pattern earlier this week, where it tried to make an attempt to settle above 7,000, but ultimately failed to hold that level. So it seems that investors might still be on a wait-and-see mode, possibly being sidelined by expectations of inflation accelerating again, which would be confirmed by the March inflation report coming out this Friday. So sentiment could have also been affected by Wall Street's weak performance last night as U.S. Treasury yields continued to climb back up and investors continue to push back on expectations on rate cuts. So looking at the bigger picture, participation has largely improved year to date, with the average hovering at around 5B for value turnover, excluding block trade. So I think that's more of a positive thing. And as for foreign activity, foreign investors have also been net buyers since the start of the year, accumulating about 10B in net buying currently.
All right, now let's talk about the COL Tech Spotlight now, which is saying the market needs to convincingly stay at about 6980 for this rally to continue, although today it was maybe this is just a wild card, the market being sympathetic to a lot of developments in foreign markets as well. Now, is there any indication, Denise, of 6980 being strong or weak?
That's right. We are expecting the market to retest the 6,800 support level and possibly trade sideways until then, until it can make a more decisive move. I think it might still be too early to say, but what we think we could monitor currently would be to watch economic data that's slated to come out later this week, and to monitor any developments overseas, particularly those that could give us any clues as to whether the narrative of, rate cut expectations later in the year should stay intact, or if we should see any negative surprises. But hopefully, in the absence of these negative surprises on the supply chain and cost pressure side, I think our base case forecast for the year at 7,100 should still be achievable. And this is under the assumption that corporate earnings could grow by around 10% this year.
All right. And Denise, of course, those were able to lock in gains recently and are in a better cash position right now. What stocks might they consider as they re-enter the market?
Right. So we would recommend for them to look to reposition on perhaps larger cap names still, and maybe those that have pullbacks of around 5 to 8% from their recent highs. So mostly getting opportunities on those that had uptrend pullbacks. So we would still recommend investors to focus on fundamentally strong companies that have outperformed the market rather than bottom picking at the moment, especially those that have fundamental issues.
All right, Denise, I'd like to go back to what you mentioned earlier about catalysts this week. You know, March inflation will, of course, set the mood for BSP rate decisions moving forward, and, you know, inflation numbers are soon due out. Now, it is expected to be hotter given how oil and food prices have gone up in the last month. What is COL's consensus now for March inflation? And maybe can you give us an idea of what trends you're seeing for CPI through the second quarter of 2024?
Right. So we are a bit on the more watchful side since we're already coming from hotter than expected February inflation numbers, which came in at 3.4%. And right, it is expected to accelerate further to 3.8% as economists are expecting currently. So I think we would have to watch more closely how rice prices will trend, since this is a big contributor to our CPI. But it seems that Palay farm gate prices haven't really exactly come down, and export restrictions from other countries haven't changed significantly. Another thing that we would have to watch would be oil, which I think seems to be trending upwards again. But you know, hopefully if these cost pressures cease to persist, we should still be on track to realizing a lower inflation rate for the full year, which I think consensus currently is penciling in at 3.5%.
All right, so that's 3.5%. Lastly, Denise, stock picks, perhaps two blue chips and two growth stocks for COL Financial.
Right, so we are still seeing some opportunities in the banking sector. So these would be CHIB and Metro Bank. Mm-hmm. Since these are still trading below book value at, I think, 0.6 and 0.8 2024 PB respectively, generally we do believe that banks would continue to benefit from borrowing rates staying higher for longer, especially in light of inflationary pressures becoming more of a concern lately. And yeah, for CHIB, our target price is 42.9, mm-hmm. While Metro Bank, we're eyeing around 87. Okay. And for the growth stocks, well, we are looking at Manila Water. Okay. Right now, our FV estimate on Manila Water is 27.8. We think that it could still benefit from the rate rebasing exercise it did recently, and improved regulatory footing of the company should provide favorable growth for their earnings momentum going forward.
All right, Denise Joaquin of COL Financial, thank you so much for this conversation. Hope you can join us again soon.
Okay, thanks, Stanley.